an ordinary day in an ordinary town. One ordinary boy was about to encounter an extraordinary experience. This is the story of Inchested.
Ew, Mom! Why are you making me eggs? You know I hate eggs!
Chester, this is all we have in the fridge right now. Be grateful for all the wonderful things we have. I'll make them yummy for you, sweetie.
Well, Mom, you stink. Jack's mom makes some waffles for breakfast. I wish I had Jack's mom!
Chester, never ever speak to your mother like that again. She is a great mother and works very hard. Besides, these eggs are delicious!
You guys are so mean! Keep your stinking eggs! I'm not eating them!
Chester! How could you? Those plates are expensive.
Go to your room right now, young man. Now!
You can't tell me what to do. I'll go wherever I want. Goodbye!
Chester's parents didn't know what had gotten into him lately. They were very disappointed. Chester went outside and crawled up high into his tree fort, his favorite place to be. However, this time in the tree fort, Chester stumbled upon something very, very different.
Whoa! What is this cool treasure chest doing up here?
So there Chester went, whirling and twirling down into this mystical chest without a clue where he would end up.
Ow! That hurt! Who are you?
Aren't meaty! You be on board the ship of the great pirate Captain Ratcracker!
You can talk!
No time for monkeying around. Come with me.
And so the talking monkey led the very confused Chester up the wooden steps to discover they were on a pirate ship. A talking monkey pirate ship filled with talking monkey pirates. The monkey pirates were screaming and swinging their swords around in the air. A sea of acrobatics rose above the other monkeys. It was Captain Blackcracker. He drew his sword to Chester's neck. Chester had to think quick.
What bring ye upon me here, barge? Be ye friend or foe?
Give me the sword, monkey!
Ah! You animal!
I be the great Chester! A friend to some, but a foe to many. I've sailed 1,000 seas, fought monsters, men, and monkey alike.
Quiet, baboons! I deem thee First Mate Chester!
Imposter! Here's an evil from you, Captain! Traitor!
What? Ye be just an ordinary boy? From an ordinary town? On an ordinary day?
Yes, it's true.
Ye be a liar and a fraud. Tie him up, boys! Walk the plank, you bag of filth!
Or should he clean the poop deck, Monsieur Captain? It is full of real poop!
Yarr! Shut your gob with a banana, Jacques! Now, Chester, walk the plank.
Ow! Ouch! Hey, that was a banana! Ew, gross! You just flung poo at me!
Chester, say ye last words, boy.
I wish I could say sorry to my mom and dad, and that I love them so much. This all happened because I was so ungrateful.
Yarr! Well, ye be grateful the foe will end your ungrateful life.
Chester thought his life was over, but then he heard some really funky singing. He thought it was a dream until...
I'm alive! What the... You're a mermaid! I can breathe, I can talk, I can swim! How is this
possible, Chester?
Huh. You know my name?
I know a lot of things, baby. Like you've been acting a fool. Listen, you got a lot of problems, Chester.
You sure do.
Mm-hmm. That's what she said.
Yeah, so many arms, I mean problems.
Holy fish! Who are you guys?
This is Lola the Angelfish.
Hiya, Tuck.
Harold the Eel.
It's a pleasure.
And Clyde the Octopus.
I ate!
The boy doesn't have time, Roxy. He needs to find his way home.
You know how I can get home? Please, I'll do anything!
Anything?
Chest!
Clyde, you got more arms than brains! Shut your damn mouth!
Roxy, you know what to do.
Hit it!
You can't
came through the trunk, cause you were in a funk. What you failed to see became your destiny. Now follow his tail, you're unlikely to fail. So if you are smart, Chester, follow your heart.
Okay, I'm never gonna be an ungrateful brat again. I'm following your tail, Harold. Let's go!
Hold on tight now. Wouldn't want you to slip away.
Whoa! Oh, no, no, no!
Harold the Eel took Chester on a magical journey, all the way back to Chester's tree fort, where he burst through the chest to see his mom and dad.
Mom! Dad!
Chester! What happened?
Honey, wow, what a great hug. You're all wet.
Yeah. Yeah, I am. I love you so much, Mom and Dad. I'm sorry for being such a brat. I'm changed. I looked inside of my own chest.
And that is the extraordinary story of the ordinary Chester. The end!